decided to act by blocking off the street. Art Cribbs has that story.
At various times, you'll see as many as 50, 60, 70 people out there selling drugs.
Charles Smith has lived on 26th Avenue in Oakland for 28 years. He says this street is a 24-hour drug supermarket. What are you going to do?
I don't know. I'm thinking seriously of selling the house.
And he's not alone. His neighbor, Eugene Brooks, is fed up as well. A couple of weeks ago, his house was shot up with bullets whizzing past his 15-year-old daughter asleep in her bed.
Gunshots came through that window from the other side and went through my daughter's window, which is right next to her bed.
So you don't even have to be in the game to be in danger.
Yeah, you could be in danger anywhere around here, anywhere.
Gunshots in houses, gunshots in parked trucks and cars. This man's car was hit twice just last night.
It hit here and it must have bounced inside, it bounced there, then it bounced again. That was one, and here's another one, and that's two.
It's a virtual war zone. The 2400 to 2600 two-block stretch on 26th Avenue.
During the day, it's not that busy. During night, again, you know, I don't know what's going on at nighttime. Yeah. It's a different city at nighttime.
When it gets dark, you can hear the competition for drug sales. Hey. One guy will try to win a client from some other dealer. The buyer just stands on this street corner, or that one over there, or over there.
In the past 2 years, police say there have been one murder, 11 assaults with deadly weapons, 8 robberies, 94 drug arrests, 19 traffic accidents, and 4 months ago, a small child was struck and killed by a speeding car. Neighbors say when the city put in speed bumps, they thought part of the problems would go away. It didn't. It slowed it down. But the problems are very much here. Now, the city council's decided to close 26th Avenue.
What do you think about closing the street?
Well, I think it's a really, really great idea because really we're tired of all the things happens here, speeding vehicles and traffic with drugs, shooting at night. So really, we're tired of those, you know.
Councilwoman Desi Woods-Jones says Oakland needs a comprehensive street closure policy.
In my district, the Sobrani Park area, where it's some of the same things going on, I'm not sure all of it is easy or as simple as saying put some barricades up. But we certainly got some of the same kinds of problems where people are basically held hostage in their own community.
What's happening on 26th Avenue is more than just a police problem. As one resident put it, even if the violence stops there, it will simply move to another street into another neighborhood. Unless the root causes are addressed, the problems will persist. In Oakland, Art Cribbs, KPIX 5 News.
Oakland city officials say the move to set up barricades is only temporary. A final decision will be made after they find out if the barricades make any difference.
Still ahead.